Okay, this week at Gamescom, we are introducing two new returning characters in the Dead or Alive series. The first character is Brad Wong, using the Drunken Fist style. He first made his appearance in Dead or Alive 3, and he was also in Dead or Alive 4, and now he's back in Dead or Alive 5. And we're also introducing Elliot. He has made an appearance in Dead or Alive 4, and he's back in Dead or Alive 5 as well. Brad Wong, well, as you know, he uses the Drunken Fist style, and we kind of wanted to introduce that in Dead or Alive series, so we started out with that in Dead or Alive 3. Brad Wong, I know in some other games, obviously, as you pointed out, like, there's a meter when, you know, when he drinks, but we kind of didn't go with that. We really wanted him to kind of show that he's drunk in the game, so with his, like, movements and everything, whether he's standing, he's always, like, just swaying around and doing motions with his arms and whatever, and he also lies down as well, so we really wanted to kind of stress the fact that, well, he is drunk and he's fighting drunk. He's a really kind of tricky character to play against. We made sure to stress his obviously Drunken Fist moves, and Dead or Alive 5 actually added a handstand for him as well, so he's quite a new characteristic for Brad Wong. We made him even trickier to fight against, actually. You can really never tell what he's going to do next, so he's very hard to read. And we wanted players to really kind of feel the pressure when they're fighting him, like, you know, as to what the heck they should do next, basically. It's like, you know, you never know what he's going to do. Whether he's going to lie down, stand up, you know, hit you when he's standing up, or just, you know, throw you when he's lying down. So it's a really tricky character to play against, yeah. Originally, when we started out actually making Elliot, we wanted to kind of add a bit of a pretty boy into the Dead or Alive series. So I think when he came out in Dead or Alive 4, I think he kind of portrayed that characteristic fairly well. He was very kind of cute looking, I guess. So in Dead or Alive 5, we wanted to give him a bit more masculinity, make him look a little bit more striking and a little bit more impactful and cool, obviously. So we focus on kind of just doing a few design touches on him to make sure that he's got a bit of that masculine kind of look to him. He's fairly characteristic when it comes to his striking. Very, very powerful direct strikes. So it's fairly easy to read, but, you know, when he lands his hit in, he's really, really powerful. He's actually a disciple of one of the original characters in Dead or Alive, Genfu. So I think he does the same style as Genfu. So the style that he does is Xingyi Chuan. So it's a Chinese martial arts style, and direct hits, very, very impactful. You know, if you kind of combine the his attacks really well, he can be a really, really, really powerful character, actually. Well, we just gave you a quick look on the two characters that we're revealing at Gamescom for the first time. Brad Wong and Elliot, returning characters from the DOA universe. Dead or Alive 5 is coming out on September 28 in Europe. September 25 in the US and September 27 in Japan on both Xbox 360 and PS3.